Only 14 to 20% of people with psychosis will have a full recovery, with the majority having recurrent episodes and relapses. Similarly, only 25% of people with depression will achieve full remission and response to pharmacological treatment. I'm Paris Alexandros Lalousis, and I'm a Priestley PhD fellow at the University of Birmingham and the University of Melbourne, based at the Institute for Mental Health and the Center for Human Brain Health. The comorbidity between psychosis and depression is exceptionally high. 40 to 80% of people with psychosis have depression, and this is indicative of a poorer prognosis. Conversely, psychotic symptoms occur in 14 to 19% of people diagnosed with major depressive disorder. Such heterogeneity presents challenges to existing diagnoses, and some symptoms have been proposed as transdiagnostic. What we mean by transdiagnostic means that different disorders share common causal and maintenance processes, and that treatments designed to treat specific disorders overlook comorbidity. Machine learning is a branch of artificial intelligence that uses data to automatically learn and improve from experience, and also detect patterns without being explicitly programmed. An example of machine learning is when you upload a picture of a person on social media, and a machine learning algorithm uses data to detect whether that person is someone you know and who it is so that you can tag them. So these machine learning approaches could aid diagnostic and treatment challenges by disentangling complex symptomatology and providing a deeper understanding of what it is that is particular about the brains and symptoms of people who present with comorbidity. This will potentially help the development of new therapies for new targets that were previously unidentified. My research uses a combination of supervised and unsupervised machine learning techniques, utilizing clinical neuroimaging and neurocognitive data from the multi-site pronia study to investigate the heterogeneity of depression and psychosis and the importance of transdiagnostic symptoms. Results so far have shown that transdiagnostic symptoms show very good ability to accurately classify categorical diagnoses in symptomatologically pure groups only, meaning that the majority of psychosis and depression patients have a transdiagnostic profile. The brain structure and symptoms reveal a similar picture and have potentially similar causes. Traditional diagnostic groups show a mismatch between their clinical picture and their brain structure, meaning that the current diagnoses that we have do not reflect the biological reality of patients. This highlights the need to do research that uses neurobiological data to define potentially new diagnoses. Using a semi-supervised machine learning approach, models built on brain imaging data suggest the presence of distinct clusters of patients who have both depression and psychosis. Each cluster of patients was formed based on the similarity of their brain structure. What this shows us is that there is a big number of people who are clinically characterized as having different disorders, but show similar brain structure. Such biologically informed clusters could potentially aid the diagnosis and prognosis of these disorders. Indeed, in the next step of my analysis, I aim to build predictive machine learning models using these biologically informed clusters and compare their ability to produce a successful and accurate prognosis compared to traditional diagnoses. Recent work at the University of Birmingham on dysfunctions of the immune system, the bodily system that controls, monitors, and responds to environmental challenges, highlights that it may be causally related to depression and psychosis. Professor Rachel Updegrove's lab, which I am part of, leads the Psychosis Immune Mechanism Stratified Medicine Study, PIMS, which investigates the role of the immune system in psychosis. Not all young people with psychosis show immune dysfunction, and we need to better understand how to stratify groups into those who may and may not benefit from immune-based treatments. Ultimately, the mental health research that we do here at the University of Birmingham paves the way for precision, personalized medicine in psychiatry. If you're interested in finding more about the research that we do, you can find me on Twitter at p_lalousis and on LinkedIn at ResearchGate if you search for my name. Thank you.